In this video, we'll talk about how to use the technique of reference to present a different image on each trial of the experiment. This project uses the technique of reference in the display image action of the recording sequence. If you double-click on a display screen action, then it will bring up the screen builder, which will allow you to see and edit the contents of that display screen action. The screen builder has several buttons at the top of its interface that allow you to add different types of screen resources to the display screen action. These buttons allow you to add images, videos, text, and basic shapes to the display screen action. In this case, we've added an image resource to the display image action. To add an image resource, you first need to have at least one image file in your project's library. To access your project's library, you can click on the button that looks like some books on a shelf, or click Edit Library Manager. You can use the Library Manager to add image files, sound files, video files, and other special files that can be useful in some types of projects. In this case, we have just added the image files that will be used by this project under the Image tab of the Library Manager. Once you have images in your library, you can go back to the Screen Builder for your relevant display screen action and use the Insert Image Resource button to add any of your image files to that action. When you add an image resource, its properties become visible in the Properties panel on the left. The Source File Name property near the bottom is one of the most important properties of the image resource. When you first add an image resource, the Source File Name property will reflect the name of the image file that you added. If you leave it like this, then on each trial, you will see the exact same image. We don't want to use the same image on every trial in this project. Instead, we want to grab the file name to be used on each trial from the image file column of the trial data source. To do so, we make what we call a reference to the image file column of the trial data source from the source file name property of the image resource. To make a reference, you can click on a property in the Properties panel to select it. When you do, you'll see a button with three dots on it appear. When you click that button, it will bring up the Attribute Editor. From the Attribute Editor, you can see a hierarchical representation of your project in the Node Selection panel. You can navigate to the various nodes of your project and click on a specific part of the experiment to display its node attributes in the middle panel of the bottom of the Attribute Editor. In this case, we can navigate to the data source component of the trial sequence to display the data source columns in the Node Attributes panel. You can double-click on any of the columns to make a reference to that column. The reference will be shown at the top of the Attribute Editor. In this case, we've made a reference to the image file column of the data source. This will make it so that the file specified in this column will be displayed on any given trial. Now, we've already done that for one image resource, so I'm going to delete this image resource that I just created. Note, the technique of referencing in Experiment Builder is not limited to just changing image files. It is one of the most important aspects of Experiment Builder. Any property that is displayed in the Properties panel and that is not grayed out can be edited to make a reference to some other aspect of the project.